Introducing the new TLRD refillable single point lubricator from SKF, available in both 150 and 250 milliliter sizes. The SKF TLRD package includes a battery pack and a fully assembled unit, which includes a translucent empty cartridge for filling and refilling with grease. The SKF TLRD unit comes fully assembled with a protective cap, which is used for protecting the device after its application. It also includes an empty grease cartridge, which can be easily attached to a drive unit and filled separately. Within this empty grease cartridge, you can find a piston, which is pushed by the drive unit during operation. Taking a closer look at the SKF TLRD drive unit, you can quickly see the top sticker where the dispense period, starting date, and grease type can be written down. After removing the top cover, you can quickly set a time setting between 1 and 12 months following the descriptive table. The battery can be quickly inserted before closing the top cover, and the device will be ready for operation. The SKF TLRD is equipped with an LED light which indicates its normal behavior when flashing green and can also indicate potential alarms or issues with the device when blinking red. This enables you to remotely track how the device is performing on the field. A blinking red LED also indicates the end of cycle. You should always replace the battery pack when starting a new lubrication cycle. Before starting a new lubrication cycle, it is highly recommended that you write down the dispense period, start date, and grease type on the top sticker of the drive unit. Before starting the filling process of an empty cartridge, it is highly recommended to lubricate the cartridge walls to facilitate the movement of the piston during the filling operation. You must first install the filling adapter, which can be easily screwed on the top of the empty cartridge. Make sure that the filling adapter is properly tightened to avoid any spillage. After installing the filling adapter, you can quickly connect the grease pump to the empty cartridge with a quick coupling. Start filling the grease cartridge with grease while carefully observing the piston's position. The piston should start moving while grease is being pushed into the cartridge. The approximate fill quantity can be checked by the external volume markings on the outside of the cartridge. We recommend stopping the filling procedure as soon as the piston ceiling is at the same level as the external O-ring of the cartridge. Pay close attention not to overfill the cartridge, as the piston may become loose and separate itself from the cartridge. If this happens, the grease cartridge should be replaced with a new one. After the filling process is completed, the grease pump can be disconnected from the empty cartridge and the filling adapter removed from the top. After filling, inspect the cartridge, check if there is any visible leaks on the top of the piston, and make sure that the piston is correctly secured inside the filled cartridge. The TLRD piston is engaged by a rotating pressure plate, which must be correctly positioned prior to starting the device. For this, the pressure plate must be turned clockwise until it sits fully retracted at the top, and then rotated back approximately 3/4 of a turn to ensure that it will sit properly on the piston when reassembling. After positioning the pressure plate, the filled grease cartridge can be attached to the lubricator body. Make sure it is properly tightened. Normally, the pressure plate will contact the piston and a small amount of grease may be pushed out. This will make sure that the grease output is started immediately after assembly. After full assembly of the lubricator, do not forget to place the protective cap on top of the drive unit before use. The filled or refilled SKF TLRD can now be mounted on your application with the use of compatible SKF accessories.